Hey everyone, my name is Philly from Philly Davis Channel. In this video, I will teach you how to invest in the stock market step by step. So grab a pen and paper and make sure to watch this video till the end. If you end up enjoying the video, then give it a huge thumbs up and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. With this, let's dig into our video. What is the stock market? The stock market is a financial market where you can buy different financial instruments such as stocks, bonds, and options. So what is a stock? A stock is a proportional part of a business that is traded in a public exchange. It represents a share of ownership in a company, so investors buy stock and other financial instruments to build a diverse portfolio that help increase his capital and mitigate risk. Now let's talk about the different types of investors and how they approach the market. Basically, there are three main types of investors, and the first one is called active investors. These investors do a lot of research and they are daily informed about the fundamental and trending news of the market. They are constantly looking for an investment opportunity and they know very well how to do financial analysis, read financial statements, and how to predict the market. Also, they have many approaches to find stocks, such as stock price, market condition, the price movements, and usually stocks that can provide short-term profits. One observation about this type of investor is that their investments are usually taxed at a higher rate than long-term investors because short-term capital gain investment is a tax as ordinary gain. Short-term capital gains can be a tax from 10% rate to 37% rate, while long-term capital gain can be taxed from 0% rate to 20% rate. The second type of investor is called passive investors. Passive investor is the classic investor who have a long-term approach to the market and they seek to avoid the fees that may occur with frequent trading. Unlike active investor, passive investors don't try to profit from short-term opportunities that are presented in the market. Passive investors usually buy index funds, stocks, precious metals, and ETFs that track major indices. Basically, passive investors seek to build a well-diversified portfolio that protect their long-term investment and mitigate risk. The third type of investor are called speculator or day traders and swing traders. Day traders are a type of speculator that buy or sell financial instruments within the same trading day. So day traders usually close all their positions before the market closes to avoid risk and negative price gaps. Day traders usually open or close their position based on price action, fundamental analysis, technical analysis, and market sentiment. Swing traders and day traders have a similar style of trading, but the main difference between them is that swing traders hold position of trades that last a couple of days up to several months. Swing traders primarily use fundamental analysis and technical analysis to look for trading opportunities. To buy or sell stocks, you need to open a brokerage account. A brokerage account is an investment account that allows investors to buy or sell stocks, bonds, options, or other types of financial instruments. There are different types of brokerage accounts and brokerage firms that help investors to fulfill their financial needs. For example, one of the most popular brokerage accounts are the discount brokerage accounts that offer some basic services and charge lower fees than full-service brokerage firms. The majority of beginners and experienced investors prefer this type of account because they can avoid paying for extra services they don't need. Another type of brokerage account is the full-service brokerage account for investors who seek a financial advisor to help them develop an investment plan. These types of accounts are expensive and sometimes have some minimum deposit requirements of $20,000 or more. If you want to know what are the best brokerage firms and where you can open free demo accounts to practice your investment skill, keep watching this video. Also, make sure to give this video a like for the YouTube algorithm. Later, I'll provide this information. Okay, now we've come to the core part of investment, and it's where you can determine your success in your investment career, and it is the research method to pick stocks and how to evaluate them. There are many research methods to find companies for new investors, and I will mention the most important here. The first one is the basic research method to pick stocks. This method is based on reading different financial newspapers, magazines, and websites such as CNBC.com, Yahoo Finance, Bloomberg.com, or Wall Street Journal. They can help you find out valuable information about potential companies you might decide to invest in. Remember, this method is all about reading different financial resources to find potential investments. The second research method is to pick stocks based on the use of a stock screener. A stock screener is a software or a tool designed to help you search for stocks based on some filters, including stock price, sector, market capitalization, PE ratio, among others. You can find stock screeners in many financial websites or trading platforms. Either they're free or you have to pay for a subscription. Some of the best free stock screeners are found in Yahoo Finance, Finviz.com, TD Ameritrade, and Bazinga, among others. Okay, now we know how to pick stocks. Let's go talk about how investors evaluate stocks. Investors apply different criteria and analysis to evaluate stocks, such as fundamental and technical analysis. Fundamental analysis evaluates stocks or any other financial instrument based on their intrinsic value by studying related economic and financial factors. Fundamental analysis is more used by long-term investors, while technical analysis is used more by traders, day, and swing traders. Technical analysis is the study of historical market data, including price and volume, to predict future market behavior. Okay, before you start investing in any stock, you must learn how to interpret and calculate the most useful financial ratio to evaluate stocks. Ratios provide insight into a company's financial health. Some of the most important ratios used by investors are the price-to-earning ratio, PE, the price-to-book value, PBV ratio, and debt-to-equity ratio. So if you want to improve your knowledge about how to evaluate stocks, I recommend that you read Warren Buffett Accounting Book by Stig Broderson. Finally, here are the three golden rules of investing for beginners. Rule number one, avoid the market trap of becoming a gambler. Nowadays, it's more easy to start investing in the stock market than any time before. Now with your cell phone, you can open a brokerage account and download an app such as Robinhood or Thinkorswing from Ameritrade and deposit money from your bank account and start investing during minutes. So many people get a false belief that they have the knowledge required to be a successful investor just because they know how to open a brokerage account and how to buy or sell stocks. Investing is one of the most difficult professions, and it requires that you master the intellectual knowledge and the emotional knowledge about the market to become a successful and consistent investor. Rule number two, write your plan and rules. Making an investment plan is essential to get success in investment. If you want to follow a process and be disciplined in your investment, you need a plan and a set of rules that keep you on track of your goals. An investment plan should assess your current financial situation, define your goals, determine your risk tolerance, decide what to invest in, and how to invest. Will you invest based on fundamental analysis, technical analysis, or both? Rule number three, test your knowledge in demo account before investing your real money. Demo account is a very important tool that allows investors to test their skills and knowledge about investment without risking their real money. You should practice in demo account until you show that you are able to consistently make money in the market. Some investors take a year or more practicing in demo accounts until they master the fundamental knowledge, the technical knowledge, and the emotional knowledge needed to be a successful investor. Remember that statistics show that 90% of investors lose money in the stock market because they lack the knowledge to become a consistent and profitable investor. Okay, this is the list of some of the most important brokers, and many of them provide demo, paper trading accounts. InteractiveBrokers.com, TDAmeritrade.com, Robinhood.com, eTrade.com, Fidelity.com, Investopedia. It's an educational website that provides a simulator for long-term investors. So this is it for today's video. Share your thoughts with me in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, then give it a like. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Thanks for checking in. See you in the next video. Until then, stay safe.